Hi guys, welcome back to my channel, and today we are going to do a tutorial on digital makeup. So for that we are going to use face recognition library. Actually that library is built on top of Dilip, so if you guys want you can directly go ahead and use Dilip. Dilip is very powerful library and it implements a lot of machine learning algorithms, and its Python bindings are also available, so you can directly use that one with a little bit change in the code. I'm using face recognition because it's really simple and straightforward to use, and also for installation you all have to do is pip install face recognition, so that's why I'll be using that library. So we'll be using Dilip's facial landmark detectors, which works really well. So it's gonna give us 68 points on the face, basically the key points of face, something like the eyebrows, the coordinates for the lips, the chin, the nose bridge. So the only tricky part in this whole tutorial will be where I add another image on top of an already existing image, something like my image is there and I have a PNG or jewelry. So after detecting my chin part, I want to add that image, that jewelry part, to my image. And also this image will dynamically shrink or grow as far as I come near or far from the camera. So that is the only tricky part. There we are going to use some image manipulation techniques, so only there you have to be careful, otherwise everything is straightforward. We are just gonna, after getting the coordinates of the lips, eyebrows and all, we just gonna draw on top of it any color we wish and then render that image on the screen. Okay, for that we are going to use pillow library. So this same technique you can also use to create Instagram filters, something like rabbit ears or Batman mask. So let me know in the comments if you want me to create an Instagram filters tutorial, I'll do that. Okay, so as usual, all the code will be available on my GitHub repo and the link will be in the description. All the installation instruction will also be there. I usually recommend you to install all these dependencies into a virtual environment. I'm gonna give you the link to a website where it's excellently mentioned how to do that. So let's get started. Hi guys, so let's start coding. Let me create new file, digitalmakeup.py. Now let me quickly just write down a command. I'm gonna just disable my linter for now. Now let's talk about the dependencies first, guys. So we need three dependencies here: OpenCV, face recognition and pillow. So the recommended way to install all this is to that you go ahead and create a virtual environment and then install all these dependencies. I'm gonna give you the link to a PY image search article. It's an excellent article. In my previous video also I explained you guys about this article. So I will give the link of this in my GitHub link. All the installation instructions you can find over here based on your operating system. They have not covered Windows operating system, so for that I'm gonna give you another link, Geeks for Geeks articles link, from which you can install a virtual environment and then set up OpenCV inside it. And also one more thing to note down is, please install this OpenCV contrive Python and not only OpenCV Python, because OpenCV contrive Python will be having some more modules that you might be needing. Okay, so let's start by importing our modules. Import CV2, import face recognition, and yes, you guys will need face recognition module. You just have to do pip install face recognition. You'll find all these instructions on the GitHub repo, so don't worry. And from pillow library we are gonna be importing image and image draw. Okay, actually guys, you can also go ahead and do this, the same things, in OpenCV itself, and you don't require basically pillow library. But pillow library is really easy to use and draw polygons and lines. Then we gonna, after finding the points for the lips, the eyebrows, when we want to draw a line or polygon, it's really easy to do that in pillow. OpenCV also it's easy, but you just need to write more code and then convert that to an NP array and all. So this is easier in pillow, so we're gonna do that with pillow library, but you are free to use OpenCV as well, no issues over there. So let me now quickly import an image. So first I'm gonna show you all these things over an image, and later we'll convert that to take it from real-time webcam feed from our camera.
because then you will be able to easily understand with the images. So I have a jewelry.png file inside one of my folders. Let me quickly show you that image. So this is the image that is going to be, and this is the another image. So basically I'm gonna add this jewelry over here after detecting this jawline, this chin area. Okay, I'm gonna add it here. So we'll see how that works. And also this is a PNG image, guys. So by default, if you want to, it will be also having an alpha channel. So if you guys want to read that one, you also have to pass one more argument, minus one, or I guess cv2.imread unchanged, something like that. So, but we are not gonna read it, because later when we perform multiple addition and subtraction of images, both images should have similar channels. So as we don't require its fourth channel, the transparent channel, I'm not gonna read it. And next is to read another image, which is my image. I am read neha1.jpg. So I'm naming it as frame because later we're gonna read it from our real webcam feed, and that is going to be a frame by frame. So I'm gonna name it like that. Now face landmarks list is equals face recognition dot face landmarks frame. Okay, so let us check this face landmarks function of face recognition library. So I'm gonna open the face recognition library's GitHub page. As you guys can see, it's a very popular library with around 32.8k stars. I'm going into face recognition api.py. Let me open face landmarks. Okay, let me just open landmarks. Okay, so as you guys can see, we are calling this function face landmarks. It's gonna return us it's gonna call another function, and after that it is gonna return us the landmarks as tuple. So we are going to get an array of all the, it is going to be basically an array of arrays, and all the arrays will be the tuple points. So let me show you quickly. It's gonna return us this 68 points. Okay, so for suppose it has detected there are two faces in this image. Now there will be an two arrays inside that inside the result that we get after calling this function face landmarks. Okay, and inside each of the arrays there will be tuples, something like this is the left eyebrow, right? So this will be tuple of xy coordinate of all these. Okay, as an array we are going to get, and as you can see at the time of returning us, so it's gonna return us this dictionary. So chin will be having these points from 0 to 17, left eyebrow will have points from 17 to 22, right eyebrow from 22 to 27. I'll show you while executing the code. I'll just print out all these points so that you guys can better understand it. Okay, so now currently what we are planning to do is I'm gonna print out the points of the chin. Let's see what all points it's gonna give us. Basically it is going to give us all these 17 points on the chin. Okay, so let me quickly do that. So first, now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna say face landmarks equals face landmarks list 0. Okay, because I know that there is only one person in the image. For now I'm just gonna take the 0th point, and now I'm just gonna print this out, face landmarks of, I would say, chin. Okay, let us run this program and check. Now I'm going to go inside my virtual environment, which I have named as CV2. You guys can see I'm inside this virtual environment. Now I'm gonna run this program. It's taking some time. So as you guys can see, okay, let me print the length of it as well. Okay. Dot length. Okay. So let's talk about this. So this is the first point, this is the second point, this is the third point, basically in this sequence, okay? And its length should be 17. List attribute has no length. Ooh, okay, sorry. I have this problem of mixing up different languages, so please forgive me, guys. Okay guys, so as you can see, the length is 17, and if I show you, these are also 17 points. Okay, so now this is the first xy coordinate for the chin area, this is the second xy point, this is the third xy point. So this is essentially an array of tuples. Okay, so essentially this is 624 and 1741. Okay, now what we want to do is we want to find out the x and y for our jewelry, where the x and y coordinate of the jewelry will start. So I would like to start it from here, this fourth point. So essentially this will be the third point in our array of tuples. So I am gonna say, first let me create a variable, shape chin equals face landmarks of chin. Okay, now I'm going to say x is equals shape of chin of, this is my fourth point, so essentially this will be third point, and zero, that means the x coordinate of this point. Okay, similarly, if I want to access the y coordinate, I would have to say shape chin 3 of 1. Okay, so this is how you access the tuples. The tuples basically 0, 0, 0, 1. This is how you can access all the tuples. Okay, just like arrays, indexing them. Now, I want to calculate the width and height of the image. So guys, this, as I also I think explained already, this image should resize based on the shape of the face, right? If I am closer to the camera or farther from the camera, I want the image to resize on its own. So our width will depend on the shape of the face that is being predicted, right? So I'm gonna take from this fourth point to 14. What's the distance between these two points horizontally? So that means I have to subtract their x coordinates of this fourth point and 14th point. Okay, so now I will say shape of, and also I'm gonna use absolute function in case it comes out to be negative, then we'll get an error. So shape chin of, this fourth means third, 30, x coordinate for this one, minus shape chin of 15, that means 14, 0. Okay, this is the width, and image height I'm gonna calculate depending on
the width of the image. So you guys can also argue that height also we can take it to be 1/3 of the face or anything like that. That's fine. But also this image is having an aspect ratio. So if I show you its info, as you guys can see, it's 850 by 859, right? So its width is approximately 1.02% of its width, right? Its height is. So I'm gonna maintain that ratio and calculate it that way, else it will get distorted. When we resize this one, this might get distorted. So I'm gonna say int of 1.02 into image width, okay, image width. Okay, let's print out the width and height. Image width, and I'm gonna say this as an F string, okay, and now I'm gonna say image height. Okay, and let me just remove these two. Okay, now after getting, okay, let's see if it prints properly. And then what I want to do is, now I want to, you know, resize our jewelry image based on this image width and height. So we're gonna say cv2.resize. Image width is not defined. Okay. Yes. It's fine only. Okay. So let me write this down, then I will run the program at once. So cv2.resize our jewelry image, or I can directly say jewel image. I think I will not require this image again. Okay, let's use this one to avoid confusion. Jewel image, okay, comma, we are gonna give images width, comma, images height, say this to be, or else maybe I can say image underscore width. Okay, image underscore height. Let me just do them like this. And this is image width, this is image height. Okay, now what I want to do is, I want to, okay, and also I need to pass one more argument here where we say interpolation equals cv2.inter. Okay, so interpolation, we use this technique to either enlarge the image or downsize the image. In our case, our image is bigger. Mostly we are going to downsize it. So whenever we downsize, we use this cv2.interarea. And whenever we are upscaling it, then we use other functions. I think linear or something like that. But now since we are downsampling our image, downsizing our image, we are going to use this function, okay? Okay, so let me do cv2.imshow. Did I import? Yes, cv2.imshow jewel image. Jewel image, and I'll say while
cv2.weight key of 10 not equal to q. Simply I'm saying until I press q I should be able to see the image. Okay, print weight. Okay, let me now run the program and check invalid syntax key. Okay, I think there is some problem with this weight key. I think this is correct. Okay, now let's see. Okay, so this is the width and the height of the image, but I don't know why it is this big, because face can't be this big. I'm gonna press Q. I don't know what will happen. I should have used chaos. Let me close this one. ORD of Q. But problem is, why is the width that big? Image, okay, whatever. Shape chin of 3, 0. Okay, let me print x and y as well. Basically, let me print both these points to see what is it. Print, okay, and also footteen 0. Okay, I'll print both the things and then we just out. So I don't know, but this is huge. I don't think so, it's this big. Okay, I also have to resize this image, as this image is very large, that's why I'm getting this issue. Okay, I got it. So let me resize my frame as well. Okay, let me resize this too. Frame equals cv2.resize frame comma 432 comma 576. I think this is fine for my laptop's screen. Now I think it should be cool. Okay, let's check. Yes, so this is in accordance to the face, and also the image that I'm using to detect the face is this image. So basically this is calculating based on the width of the chin areas, and I think this is by far okay. Okay, so this is our resized image. Now, so this works fine for us. So let me just comment this out. Okay. Now, what I would like to do is, first I will get the gray version of this image. cv2.cvt color shell image comma cv2 dot color dot color underscore pgr to gray. Okay, so now why I need this gel part is the gray part is because now I'm going to do something called thresholding. Okay, so pay close attention here guys. Let me just first quickly write it down and then I'm gonna explain you what I'm trying to do with this thresholding thing is I'm going to say, okay, for this particular pixel, okay, let me write it down first and then explain you guys. Threshold will take so this function only takes the gray image, that's why we have converted our image to grayscale. And then I'm gonna say something like 230 and then 255, then I'm gonna say cv2 dot thresh binary. Okay, now what it does is it says that in this grayscale image all the pixels which are greater than 230 should be converted to 255, and all the lesser ones which are less than 230, so based on this condition, thresh binary will say that all the ones which are less than 230 will be converted to black. Okay, now let me quickly show you this jewel mask and then explain. And there is also a return threshold value which we don't need over here, so that's why I'm ignoring it. Okay, jewel mask, basically this will now okay, I'll show you. See guys, so this was our original image, so it has marked all the portion of the jewelry as black and everything else is marked as white. Okay, so these pixels are basically greater than 230, so they are all marked black. Still I think there is some places where it is still white. Okay, you guys can play around with this. So if you use any other image or anything else, you guys have to set this value accordingly. You have to play around with these values. Okay, now why I created the jewel mask is because everything, so in OpenCV the black value is represented as 0, so whatever you add to black value is going to be that value. Okay, so now what I want to do is, okay, let me do this one and then show you all the three images together so you guys can better understand it. Jewel mask. Okay, now I will say, okay, now I'll say something like jewel image, wherever jewel mask is 255, that means wherever jewel mask is white, I want to make it as black. Okay, okay, so now in jewel image I'm saying is wherever this portion is white, I would like to make that portion as black in the original jewelry image. Okay, so basically this is my jewelry image, this transparent part I want to convert that to black. Basically this is the same principle when I add this image to my other image. So for suppose this is the rectangle that we are cutting down, so whatever black portions will be my original image, when gets added it will render those parts of the image. Okay, so it doesn't looks like there is a square area where this image is lying around. Okay, so now let me just print Q and quit it. Now after doing this, I want to do is I want to specify a jewel area which will be cut down from the frame. So we already calculated on top our y and x coordinates for the jewelry. So I'm gonna say y 2y plus image height comma x2 x plus image width. Okay, now I can say masked jewel area is equals cv2 dot bitwise n. Okay, and I'm gonna put in our jewel area comma mask is equals our jewel mask. Okay, now let's see what is this mask jewel area, and then let me explain you what I have done here. Bitwise and, okay, the spelling mistake. This is a spelling mistake. Bitwise and, okay. See, so now this black image got superimposed on our original image. Okay. Now what I would like to say is, when you bitwise and, so this black portion is gonna stay as it is. So and basically zero will cancel out all the area which is over there. So now we have masked this image over here. Okay, let me change the position of the jewelry because it's coming slightly over the mouth. So if you guys can see, this is basically coming over this portion. I want to slide it down a little bit. So that's why I'm gonna select my XY to be different. Currently it is 3, that means this one, I would like to make it 4. So let me quickly make it 4. Okay, let me quit this one. Okay, now it looks fine to me. Still it looks, it's overlapping over here, but I think it should be fine. If not, later on we'll try to change that one. Okay, so now you can see we are going to work only with this area and later on add this area to our original image. Okay, so now we are working only in this area. Once this area is ready, basically this part, we want this yellow to be superimposed over here, and then this image adjacencies will cut and paste over this part of the image. Okay, this frame area, basically this XY coordinates will replace with this one. So this comes and gets added over here. So that's our main intention. Now let me, okay, and whenever you are quitting, guys, this has to be in the focus when you are pressing Q. If you go into your terminal and press Q, then the program is never gonna end. Okay, cool. Now after getting the mask jewel area, I'm gonna say, let me rename it as final jewel. I don't know if I could have renamed it appropriately, but yes, I do struggle with good variable names. Now cv2.add masked jewel area. Okay, mask jewel area plus the jewel image. Okay, so now I'm gonna take this mask jewel area and add it to my image where the other portion is white. Okay, let me show you quickly what is jewel image. Let me show all the three windows. This one, okay, this one will be our jewel image, another one will be our jewel mask, and the third one will be our final jewel. Okay, so this is our final jewel. Let me minimize this too. Okay, this is the one and this is the one. Okay, so as you guys can see, this was our image. We have removed all the white portion, transparent portion to be black. Okay, and this was our mask. So first what we did was we took our mask and superimposed on the on the jewel area. Okay, so basically jewel area is like the area of our original image. Okay, this is this. Okay, let me print jewel area also to avoid any confusion. Okay, now I'll say jewel area. Let me quit all these three. Okay, see these three images. This is one, this is one, this is one, and this is one. Okay, so now this jewel area is the portion that we cut out from the image. Okay, this jewel mask was made out of our original jewel image where we masked everything to black and then white. And this one was our original image. We made this one as white, right? So now what we did is first, after creating our jewel mask, we have bitwise and jewel area and jewel mask. Okay. Now this is jewel area and jewel mask. Now when I do bitwise and, this black is gonna go and get superimposed over here. Okay, on that part. So now this part became black and other part became as usual the other part is. Okay, and now okay, after that what we did was we added the this mask jewel area and jewel image. Okay, so now this is our jewel image. And okay, let me print the mask jewel image to avoid any confusion. Mask jewel image, mask jewel image and jewel image. Basically all I want to do is convert the background of that jewelry image to black, so later when it gets added to other image directly, that other image can take that place. Yeah, now you guys can see it clearly. This was our mask jewel area. Okay, this was our jewel image. And then when we added both of these, we got, because this area was black, so when we added, not bitwise and, normal adding, so this yellow will become this one. Okay, and now the other portion here, this is black, so this image will become, so essentially we'll get our image plus the jewelry part. Okay, hope this is now clear to you guys. Now let me comment this out, all the things. And now after doing the final gel, we are gonna take from our original frame, we're gonna say white to, let me just take this part and replace it with our final gel pixels. Final gel. Now I can show you the correct frame directly. This is our final frame. Okay, so this is the image. As you guys can see, it should be a little bit left aligned and a little bottom from the top. So what I'm gonna do is, we are already playing with 4-0 and 4-1. Okay, so I can say is 4. If I say 5, let's see what happens with that. Let me take this as 3-0, this one as 3-1, let me see what happens. So now if I throw in one more thing, Okay, it looks fine from x-axis, just that it should be little below in y-axis. So what I can say is y I can take up as this ninth points y. So I will say 8, 7, 1. Quit this window. Okay. Yeah, this is fine, but it should be a little bit more up. So instead of 7, 7, 1, basically this will be 7, 1. I will say 6, 1. See, you guys also have to play around with these areas a little bit to tweak it so that it fits your images properly. I think I still need a little more. So what I'll do is I'll convert this to 5m maybe. See guys, I can't give here relative pixels like pixel value something like 14, 12, because it will not scale well with your images. So you always have to give it in terms of the face that is getting detected. Now it seems perfect to me. Now I also want to test run it on a very an image which is taken from far, right? Now here we will see whether it works or not. So let me just take that image to be 2. Let's see how it works on that image. Okay, yes, see, this looks so perfect and awesome. Okay, so we are done with this part of the image.
Okay guys, so now let us find the key points for lips and the eyebrows and then just color it up. So before doing that, I'm not gonna show this frame anymore via I am sure, but I'm gonna use pillow library because it's easier to draw as compared to using the same techniques in OpenCV. So I'm gonna say cv2.cvt color. Our frame, comma cv2.color underscore bgr 2 rgb. okay, now I'm gonna say, so guys, why I'm doing this is because OpenCV and Pillow both uses different formats. OpenCV is going to use the bgr format as well as and whereas Pillow is gonna use rgb format. So that's why I'm converting bgr to rgb. And now I'm gonna say image dot from array rgb image and then draw equals image draw dot draw pill image rgba. Okay, so we are taking RGBA because we also want the opacity of the images when we are coloring them. Okay, so now literally I have to say draw dot polygon and I'm gonna say face landmarks of left eyebrow. Okay, and then I'm gonna pass a color. So since this is gonna give us an array of tuples, this is what the polygon function is gonna take first to draw the polygon. And then fill, we are gonna pass the RGBA points. So let me go and find a color for the eyebrow, which is black color. Just take it and it's 12%, 10%. Let's just paste it over here.
Last one I would say 100. We'll just see what it gives us. And because, okay, now let me quickly copy this one and then say left eyebrow, and then here this should be right eyebrow. Okay, now I am gonna do the same thing for top lip, bottom lip, left eye, right eye. And then also what I want to do is I wanna draw. Okay, first let's do these things, then we'll talk as we go. After that, this should be top lip, top underscore lip. This should be bottom lip. Okay, now this should be my left eye and right eye. Left eye. And then this is going to be my right eye. Okay, now these are black colors. For my top lip and bottom lip, I want to use a pink color. I would say this seems good to me. Top lip, bottom lip. Now left eye, right eye. I'm gonna just copy this points. Okay, this is the same thing. Okay. Okay, now I can say PIL image dot show. Okay. Let's see. Okay, as you guys can see, let me change the image now because this is the another image of ours. You have one. Okay, so as you guys can see, let me open the original image as well, and then you guys can compare side by side what has just happened. So we have colored the eyebrows. We also drew a line around left eye and right eye, and we also added a lipstick and a jewelry. So now I want to add a bindi over here. I don't know what we call that in English. So basically a circle in the middle of the eyebrow. So let's go ahead and find that out. So in our landmarks, so there is no point over here. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna draw it adjacent to 22. And also for drawing a circle, we can draw an ellipse. It will have a radius. So to calculate the radius, I'm gonna say this x coordinate of 23 minus 22 by 4. So that when the radius, as you can know, the circle's diameter will be 2r. So it will be 1/2 of this distance. It seems quite okay to me. Okay, so let me just do that here properly. I would say x of, what does I say, center of eyebrow, I will say center eyebrow, okay, is equals face landmarks. Now this is our left eyebrow, left eyebrow. It's 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 4th points x coordinate, that means 0. Okay, and similar thing I will say y of center is also going to be its y coordinate. Okay, this one is the y coordinate of the same point. It's x coordinate and it's y coordinate basically. Okay, so we want here x and here y basically. I want it at x minus r. So x, actually we can take this 28th point. It's x and this y. So y will be here and x will be this one. So basically this nose bridge 0th point. What I can say is nose bridge 00 and left eyebrows 41. And our radius should be 1/4 of int of 1/4 of, so the distance between these two, so I would say face la, come on, okay. Left eyebrows x point this one, and now right eyebrows 00 minus right eyebrows 0 and 0 x coordinate of this point. Okay, now this is the radius. Now let's draw an ellipse. So I will say draw dot ellipse. It's gonna take n x minus r comma y minus r. Okay, now x plus r comma y plus r. Okay, basically you're gonna add a radius and subtract a radius from x. So if I subtract from x, this is the x point, basically this side and to this side, and then the second argument will be fill it up with a color. I'm gonna take this color, top lips color, and I'm gonna just add it over here. And okay, bill image dot show. Let's see. Okay. Well, I didn't see that getting rendered over here. What could be the issue? Draw dot ellipse. Fill it with some color, top lip color. Yeah. Okay, there is no point here. This is the proper way to draw, I think, but not sure. There is no point over here. Basically, there is no point over anywhere. Let me change this color to some other color. I don't know, maybe red. Let me take this color. I don't know if the opacity is the problem. I'm gonna say 10%. Okay. But I don't see any bindi getting rendered over here. I couldn't send. Okay, maybe this radius is coming as wrong, that's why it's not. Let me just see what is this R. Print R. Let's see what's our R. I'm guessing that this R is close to 0 or something, that's why. Okay, that's minus 154. So I'm gonna say absolute. Basically, I think I have subtracted the opposite x points. Let's see if our R is positive now. Now CRS6. Still I don't see any improvement. RS6 now. X and Y. Let me print X and Y as well because I'm not sure what's happening here. X point, comma X. Comma. Okay, it is over here. That's the problem. It's coming here. How come? Nose bridge 00, left eyebrow 41. Nose bridge. This is nose bridge, if I know it correctly. Okay, I'm using X and Y from this top shapes. Okay guys, 1 minute. X and then Y. And this Y. Invalid syntax. What's happening over here? I think I copied something wrong over here. X minus R, X plus R. Okay, I think I just copied something. I don't know what I have copied. Okay, now X will be replaced. X is fine, Y was the problem. Y. Okay, now it should work fine. The colors also I should properly. Okay. As you guys can see, our makeup look is complete. And okay guys, so let us now convert this to take up these images from real webcam feed. So I'm gonna do is say cap is equal cv2 dot video capture. 0 means my first camera. Okay, now we'll say while true red comma frame is equals to cap dot read frame by frame, and then if not red continue. So if the return value is false, that means the frame is not read correctly. We want to continue the loop in that case. Okay, now we have got the frame, we have got the, and we don't need this one anymore. We're gonna say for face landmarks in face landmarks list, and then we perform all these actions as it is. Okay, and also now instead of showing pillow image, we have to convert this back to Opencv format to render it. So what I'm gonna say is Opencv image is equals to cv2.cvt color numpy dot array fill image comma cv2 dot color underscore bg rgb2 bgr. Okay, now we'll say cv2 dot im show frame comma opencv image, and then we'll say if cv2 dot weight key of 1 in, basically we'll say double equals ord of q, then we will break from here, and after breaking we want to release all the resources, so cap dot release, and also cv2 dot destroy all windows. Okay, now this is done, let's quickly run it. Still my webcam is not getting switched on. Okay, I got some error. Jewel area, jewel mask. Okay, I don't need these things. Is it fine now? Let us run and check it once. As you guys can see, my system has completely hanged now. So I think I have to change this program a little bit. Maybe what you guys can do is, instead of converting here from pillow to OpenCV, what we can do is we can do this on OpenCV itself, no need of converting it back and forth between PIL images. One improvement, this can be done to make it work fine, or else you can remove these parts and only render the image we are adding the jewelry. That should work fine. So that's it for this tutorial, guys. I'll try to update this and make it efficient and post it on my GitHub. Till then, you will find all the code that I have shown in the program. So if you guys like this video, please like and subscribe to my channel. Please follow me on GitHub and Instagram, and thank you so much for watching. Bye.